Good day, everyone. My name is Christine Joy Bendelia Senes, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Do you have an idea what is our topic today? So stay tuned and enjoy.
Do you know what is financial stability?
Financial stability can be defined as a condition in which the financial system is not unstable. It can also mean a condition in which the three components of the financial system, financial institutions, financial markets, and financial infrastructure are stable.
Financial stability is important as it reflects a sound financial system, which in turn is important as it reinforces trust in the system and prevents phenomena such as a run on banks, which can destabilize an economy.
Example of financial stability: your ability to handle financial hardships, a job loss, or a large unexpected expense are all examples of being financially stable. If you need to use a credit card or take a loan to handle emergencies, then you're still not quite to the point of having total financial stability.
These are the 10 strategies in reaching financial stability. Number 1. Make savings automatical. This should be your top priority, especially if you don't have a solid emergency fund yet. Make it the first bill you pay each payday by having a set amount automatically transferred from your checking account to your savings.
Number 2. Control your impulse spending. The biggest problem for many of us, impulse spending on eating out and shopping and online purchases, is a big drain in our finances, the biggest budget breaker for many, and a sure way to be in dire financial straits.
Number 3. Evaluate your expenses and life frugally. If you've never tracked your expenses, try the 1 month challenge. Then evaluate how you're spending your money and see what you can cut out or reduce. Decide if expense is absolutely necessary, then eliminate the unnecessary.
Number 4. Invest in your future. If you're young, you probably don't think about retirement much, but it's important, even if you think you can always plan for retirement later.
Do it now. The growth of your investments over time will be amazing if you start in your 20s.
Number 5. Keep your family secure. The first step is to save for an emergency fund, so that if anything happens, you've got the money.
Number 6. Eliminate and avoid debt. If you've got credit cards, personal loans, or other such debt, you need to start a debt elimination plan. List out your debts and arrange them in order from smallest balance on the top of the largest at the bottom.
Number 7. Use the envelope system. This is a simple system to keep track of how much money you have for spending. Let's say you set aside 3 amounts in your budget each payday. 1 for gas, 1 for groceries, 1 for eating out. Withdraw those amounts on payday and put them in 3 separate envelopes.
Number 8. Pay bills immediately or automatically. One good habit is to pay bills as soon as they come in. Also, as much as possible, try to get your bills to be paid through automatic deduction.
Number 9. Read about personal finances. The more you educate yourself, the better your finances will be.
The last one is to look to grow your net worth. Do whatever you can to improve your net worth, either by reducing your debt, increasing your savings, or increasing your income, or all of the above. Look for new ways to make money or to get paid more for what you do.
The signs of being financially stable.
Number 1. You never overdraw your checking account. Even if you have overdraft protection in your checking account, you still prefer to keep a cushion in your account rather than relying on the protection.
Number 2. You don't lose sleep over finances. When you go to sleep at night, you tend to sleep deeply and peacefully. And if anything does keep you awake, it's usually not related to financial matters.
Number 3. you're never late with payments. This is partly because you always have plenty of money to pay your bills, but also because of your preference for being ahead of your finances rather than behind. This is also a big reason why you don't lose sleep over your finances. When you go to bed at night, you know that your bills are paid and all is right in the world.
Number 4. You pay your bills ahead of time. Part of the reason why you're never late with payments is that you pay your bills ahead of time. In fact, you probably pay them as soon as they come in. You do this because you don't like bills to linger and simply don't like owing anybody anything.
Number 5. People ask your opinion about financial matters. One of the biggest outward signs that you are financially stable is when people ask your opinion about financial matters. They'll do this because they see you as being someone who has figured it out, at least when it comes to money.
Number 6. You're generally happy with your financial situation. This doesn't mean that your financial situation is completely perfect, but rather that your finances are in balance and you are satisfied with the direction that things are heading. Even if you have financial challenges over the horizon, you have some sort of plan set up to deal with it before it comes.
Number 7. You have no ugly credit card balances. It's not at all unusual for people who have high incomes and a large number of financial assets to also carry great big, ugly credit card balances. That's not a game that you play. You absolutely refuse to carry credit card balances that can be paid off relatively quickly.
Number 8. You contribute a double-digit percentage of your pay to retirement. Many people contribute nothing more than the minimum percentage that they need in order to get the maximum employer match on their retirement contributions.
Number 9. You can afford to buy the things you really want. If you really want something, you go out and buy it. Your finances are strong enough to enable you to get those things that you really want.
Number 10. You're a natural saver. This is one of the key habits in becoming financially stable, and it's one that you mastered a long time ago. You've been doing it so long and so
that you are virtually a natural saver.
Can do it with a sense of purpose and without ever feeling any pangs of self-denial.
Integrating financial literacy in the curriculum. Financial literacy may be defined as understanding of financial products, services, and concepts to make informed choices, avoid pitfalls, know where to go for help, and take other actions to improve their present and long-term financial well-being.
Why is financial literacy in the curriculum is important?
Teaching financial literacy in the classroom is one promising way to improve financial capacity for today's young people.
Research shows that by the age of 12, students will develop an economic understanding that researchers describe as essentially adult.
How to teach students about financial stable?
Start by teaching them about budgeting and managing expenses.
Explain how credit works, why it's important, and how to use credit cards responsibly.
Stress the importance of saving and introduce the basic ways to invest money.
To sum it up, the goal behind teaching financial literacy is to help people develop a stronger understanding of basic financial concepts. That way, they can handle their money better.